Samsung would have a hard time convincing anyone that the S26 Ultra with Exynos 2600 is great. The next maxed out champion from Sammy might ditch the Snapdragon chipset. Up until 5 minutes ago, we were joyfully expecting the S26 Ultra, Samsung's next best flagship, to land with Snapdragon 8 Elite 2, also known as Snapdragon 8 Gen 5, on board. You know, Qualcomm's next top shelf processor. However, we might find ourselves in a completely different reality come January 2026, when the S26 Ultra is expected. We might get the phone with the Exynos 2600, Samsung's next in-house chipset. At first glance, one may assume that their disappointment is enormous and their day is now wrecked. Why? Let's see if there's room for panic. For the final three Galaxy S Ultra models from the S23, S24, and the S25 families, Qualcomm's silicon was essentially mandatory. Samsung sometimes packs different chips for the same Galaxy S phone, depending on the country it's sold in. While certain markets got the Snapdragon treatment, others paid the same price for a handset with Exynos inside. While many who got the Qualcomm silicon didn't grumble, others weren't on cloud nine with the Exynos. The major aggravation comes from performance and efficiency differences. Snapdragon variants frequently run faster, handle heat better, and give longer battery life. Meanwhile, Exynos devices have a tendency of lagging behind in benchmarks and efficiency. You can see why some might panic, and they could be right to an extent. Here comes the inevitable, but since the narrative isn't as black and white as it would seem. The Exynos 2600 is shaping up to be considerably different from its predecessors. It's likely to be made on Samsung Foundry's superior 2-nanometer process, putting it a generation ahead of today's 3-nanometer Snapdragon 8 Elite. On paper, that should mean more efficiency and more raw power. Samsung's prior troubles with Exynos CPUs are no secret. They often ran hotter and fell behind Snapdragon equivalents. But this time, early indicators predict a turnaround. Geekbench listings show the Exynos 2600 achieving 3,309 in single core and 11,256 in multi-core, edging out the Snapdragon 8 Elite and even beating Apple's iPhone 16 Pro in multi-core performance. Compared to Qualcomm's future Snapdragon 8 Elite Gen 2, it's nearly neck and neck. There are new techniques on the hardware side too. A revised thermal system called the heat path block is purportedly incorporated to keep things cooler under load. And for graphics, Samsung has altered gears. Instead of counting on AMD, it has pulled in experts from Huawei to help design its first wholly in-house GPU. This first version might not crush the competition out of the gate, but it creates a framework for Samsung to enhance swiftly in future generations. Even with outstanding figures on paper, Samsung faces a stiff uphill struggle in convincing normal users that the Exynos 2600 is equally as good as, or even better than, a Snapdragon. Tech-savvy users already know the past reputation of Exynos chips, but the true challenge rests with the general public, consumers who have just heard whispers that Snapdragon is better. For them, the name recognition alone carries weight, and many may assume that an Exynos-based phone is automatically a downgrade. Samsung's marketing staff will need to explain the story without drowning customers in technical language. Talking about nanometers and core counts won't land with casual shoppers. Instead, they'll have to stress real-world benefits: smoother gaming, longer battery life, cooler operating, and no compromises on camera performance. Even yet, suspicion will linger, especially in places that have felt shortchanged by Exynos devices. The organization will need more than charts and graphs. It will require hands-on proof, glowing reviews, and consistent performance in daily use to win over skeptical buyers. In fact, Samsung's main challenge isn't the Exynos 2600 itself, but the assumption that Exynos equals second best. A fresh leak concerning Samsung's future Galaxy S26 series includes photographs of cases for the S26 Pro, Galaxy S26 Edge, and S26 Ultra. Samsung's future portfolio of non-foldable flagship smartphones, the Galaxy S26 series, is slated to include three devices: the S26 Pro, S26 Edge, and S26 Ultra. Leaked renders of these phones had revealed information on their design, and the leaked case shots gave us an even closer look at them. Now, we have further leaked photographs of cases for the three phones, giving us another look at the trio. A total of 19 photos of cases for the Galaxy S26 series from various brands have leaked online, courtesy of Keep Up With Them UI. They show the three devices up close from various perspectives. As you can see in the photographs as shown, all three phones have camera islands, with the one on the S26 Edge covering the complete width of the handset, which, to be honest, looks a bit weird. While the S26 Pro has three cameras, the S26 Edge has two cameras, and the Galaxy S26 Ultra has four cameras. These photos also demonstrate that the phones feature rounded corners and flat sides exactly like their predecessors. Lastly, the photographs demonstrate that they will support QI2 with these cases. Recently, we learned that Samsung may use the in-house designed Exynos 2600 and Qualcomm's recently announced Snapdragon 8 Gen 5 CPUs for these handsets, depending on the location. Other data about these phones, including their display, camera, and battery characteristics, are now available. The display of the S26 Ultra is developed to give an immersive and visually engaging experience, featuring ultra-thin bezels and a centered punch-hole selfie camera. The screen achieves an almost edge-to-edge design that maximizes viewing space while keeping a clean and unobtrusive look. This design concept represents Samsung's approach to merging functionality with elegance. Whether you're streaming high-definition films, engaging in mobile gaming, or simply surfing, the immersive display ensures your focus remains on the content. The seamless combination of design and function maintains the premium sense that people expect from a flagship product. Samsung has enhanced the ergonomics of the Galaxy S26 Ultra to boost comfort and usability. The device boasts gently rounded corners, which not only contribute to a sleeker, more modern design, but also make it simpler to grip during lengthy use. Rubberized sides improve grip, decreasing the possibility of unintentional drops, while the presence of lanyard cutouts, a rare feature in high-end smartphones, adds an added layer of utility. These intelligent design choices demonstrate Samsung's grasp of how consumers engage with their devices daily, making sure that the S26 Ultra is as comfortable to use as it is visually beautiful. One of the most remarkable design characteristics of the S26 Ultra is its translucent back panel. This feature offers a unique peek into the phone's internal components, giving a futuristic design that sets it apart from competitors. Paired with the rubberized sides, the transparent back not only enhances the device's visual attractiveness, but also contributes to its longevity. This combination of unique materials underlines Samsung's ability to push design limits while preserving the superior quality that marks its Ultra series. The S26 Ultra exemplifies a design philosophy focusing on evolution rather than revolution. By bringing modest updates, such as improved ergonomics, a slimmer profile, and superior materials, Samsung has developed a smartphone that feels both familiar and fresh. These refinements ensure that the S26 Ultra caters to long-time customers of the S25 Ultra, while also enticing new consumers. By focusing on gradual upgrades rather than abrupt changes, Samsung has developed a flagship that mixes innovation with continuity. As a flagship handset, the S26 Ultra is positioned to compete directly with other high-end smartphones, including Apple's iPhone 17 Pro. Samsung's emphasis on refinement and usability is meant to attract both existing Ultra series users and those seeking a premium smartphone experience. While leaks have mostly highlighted design and ergonomic changes, the possibility for hardware and software advancements might further strengthen the S26 Ultra standing in the competitive market. By focusing on creating a balanced and polished product, Samsung intends to solidify its reputation as a leader in the high-end smartphone sector. The Samsung S26 Ultra reflects a measured approach to flagship design, focusing on refinement and user-centric features. From its powerful camera system and immersive display to its ergonomic form and unique materials, the S26 Ultra delivers a tempting combination for consumers seeking a high-end smartphone. By building on the merits of its predecessor and offering smart refinements, Samsung has built a device that seems like a natural evolution. As competition with Apple's iPhone 17 Pro intensifies, the S26 Ultra's focus on balance and usability may prove to be its defining strength in the premium smartphone market. So that's all we know for now. We'll be sure to keep you updated as soon as we have more information. Thanks for watching.